Hey guys, this is Steven. I've had a lot on my mind in the past 24 hours. You know, I know sometimes I can be a little lethargic in my advocacy. I can be a little bit long-winded. I can be, you know, whatever you want to call it. I really honestly don't care. I'm at a position in my life to where I'm tired. I'm very, very tired. I'm tired of hearing voices. I'm tired of have an aberrant thought. I'm tired of feeling like I never measure up. Okay, so what I'm gonna tell you today, guys, is don't be like me to a degree. Okay, what I want you to do is be triumphant. I'll use an example. I know a young man who actually has been struggling in his school scholastics. He's been struggling in his ability to make the grade. But I told him, I said, if you put your best foot forward, things will definitely happen for you. The world will open up for you. The universe will manifest its purpose for you if you decide to never give up, all right? So I'm gonna use myself as a secondary example, okay? I hear voices all day long, okay? I hear voices in my head. I hear voices on the wind. I hear voices next door. I hear voices come out of the sound of the dishwasher washing dishes, being in the bathroom. The shower head is sitting there talking to me and stuff like that. I'm tired. I'm very, very tired. But at the same time, I will not give up. Okay? I won't do it. So to a degree, I'm angry. But to another degree, I'm actually elated. I am, because I am who I am. I'm an individual. We all have our own part to play in this great drama called life. You need to figure out where you belong, and you need to figure out how to capitalize on that energy. We're all beings of energy. You know, eventually I'm going to take this this camera out into the world and start talking to people and find out what's going on with their lives and find out how they live with schizophrenia, and you know how their family members feel about their sons and daughters suffering every single day in the ears. You know, apologize for my haircut. I haven't had a haircut in about 4 weeks. So, but I mean, I'm a robust man, mentally and physically. You know, I mean, sometimes you can't get around some of the circumstances of your life or the things that you've been dealt with. Okay. What I expect you to do is to never give up. I expect you to always, always seek the best within yourself. Seek the best from yourself. And never let anybody tell you that you can't do something, okay? Because when I was diagnosed, the prognosis was I'd never amount to anything. I would lay in my bed and just deteriorate and like a carcass for the next 15, 20 years, and then I'd be fed a meal, get up, drink some water, take my meds, and go back to bed. All right. I refuse to die like that. I refuse to live a life like that, because that's not living. You know, a lot of people that are sitting there watching these videos is probably sitting there saying, oh, he's monotonous, he's boring, he's monotone, blah, blah, blah. But that's not the case of it. Right now, I'm a little angry. I'm a little angry at the fact that why do we even have to have mental illnesses in this world? Why do we have to have mothers in their beds crying because their son can't get out of bed because he hears voices all the time? How does that brother feel knowing that he can't reach his brother because his brother is gone mentally? His brother is wilting away. But I'm going to tell you guys this. If you give up, you're giving up not only on yourself, but the God that exists within you. You're giving up on the person that believes in you before you even believed in yourself. So never give up. Never give up and be prosperous in life. Don't let these circumstances define who you are. Don't let the world tell you who you are. Figure out who you are and run with it. Run as fast as the wind. And be patient, because it will come.